please give a warm welcome to Aaron, Shannon, and Allison. Oh.
So what I was doing is I decided that I would make the introduction to the webcomic. So I was like, so this is the poster that I made to be like, hey, this is our webcomic and this is some characters and this is what the characters are. And for my infographic, I decided to make a little thing about like how to make a poster, because it seems kind of simple, but there's a little bit more that goes into it. For example, like you need to think of a color scheme, that's very important. If you don't have a good color scheme, it's not gonna look very good. And then you need like elements and principles of design, like line, shape, pattern, and contrast, for a little example. And then also you need to like make sure everything is structured correctly, so you don't want your text to be over a line. You want it to like be structured and stuff like that. So this was the behind the scenes of making the poster. I first had this idea of like looking into the world of where Warlock takes place, but I then decided to add a little psychedelic kind of background. As you can see, the squares circling, and I put the characters at the bottom. I put the characters that Shannon had designed, and then I put a little bit of info about each character and an overview of the webcomic. And this is yes.
Thank you. Okay. So I am an avid comic reader. Well, specifically webcomics. I really love webcomics. Well, I really wish I had a thumb this long. So for my research, I did a lot of reading of said webcomics, specifically from the site Webtoon, which is where I wanted to format my comic based off of. This is my character. His name is Stark. This is the character that I've had for a couple of years now. I introduced to Aaron and Allison. And in my infographic, I tried to do it in the format usually used in Webtoon, very middle lined, particularly boxless. And for our process, this is the process for the webcomic. So I had an initial sketch for it, and then I would do the background, the first parts of the drawing, and then we have the final comic down here at the bottom. So when it all comes together, here are the four panels of the webcomic. And this is the opening scene where he is introduced to the main antagonist of the comic.
For mine, I did an AR animation to help promote. So, actually, bring my foreground because it's on my phone. Like the actual animation part.
Are you asking me?
Yeah.
What are you asking exactly?
Like, basically, just in the actual animation, I have to use my phone. So, should I bring my phone around?
Your presentation. Your presentation's up to
right.
You. You have to walk around for
every
city, right?
Well, so basically.
Your choice.
I animated this. I'm going to talk about it, but basically, so what I had, So for researching, I was like, so I went in knowing nothing about AR and just knowing about animation, and I had the foolish idea, this is probably going to be a piece of cake. in a week. No. That was not gonna happen. I ended up having to redo it twice because I lost all my files. Whoops. And so I had to look stuff up a lot. Here's my infographic and here's the animation. I also originally had a lot more animation going on because I didn't realize how hard bringing animation into AR was. It's very hard. Basically, you have to bring it into like an editing software and do all sorts of formatting stuff so the AR knows, oh wait, this is an animation, not a photo. And yeah, that was hard. And here's also my infographic about how to make an AR picture. So basically, you start off by making like your animation, your drawings. You should probably just stick to drawings though. And have everything on a separate layer, because basically how the AR formats it is it takes each different layer, and depending on how they're placed in the program, since it's a 3D program, so you're putting 2D images into a 3D program, it will then, when you put the app over the image along with the code, it will say, oh wait, this is like how all the spacing looks. And then you basically just move around each of the pieces after you bring it into the software, and then you get it on. That's very oversimplified version. So basically, everything is a lot of work, but it's really fun to do as a group.
So eventually for WOG, we are thinking about making further editing and possibly posting it on Webtoon. So we want to see how far we can go with this. So for Allison's AR, it is actually interactive, and she has an app on her phone. So if you ever want to talk to her later to see it, you can open up your phone and you can put it against the Zapworks AR, and you can see basically this 3D world, which is what she's created. And I think it's a really cool thing you should look at later. So thank you very much, and I really hope to record a copy.
So just you should all know that you're going to be doing some AR stuff in digital media next year as part of the curriculum. And if anybody else has an AR presentation, you should let us know in advance, because we can hook up your phone to the screen and you can actually see that. So maybe after the break, I'll put your phone up. We'll take your phone and actually do it, and then people can see. Because talking about it is not the same as actually seeing it in action, right? So after the break, I'll get your phone. All right. Any questions or comments? So, yes.
But I think that's really cool that you guys were able to collaborate on something all together and create all these different aspects of it.
So when we'll take a break and then we'll come back and do the phone and then we'll start with Dylan. Okay? Thank you, everybody.
Okay. So I'm done.